called a final thing. I am that last, that final thing. The body in a white sheet listening. The whole of me trained, curled like one great ear on a sound, a noise I know, a woman talking in another room, the woman I love. And though I can't hear her words, by their voicing, I can guess she is telling a story. Using a voice which speaks to another, weighted with that other's attention, and avowing it by deepening in intention. Rich with the fullness of what's declared, this voice points away from itself to some place in the hearer, sends the hearer back to himself to find what he knows. A saying full of hearing, a murmuring full of telling, and compassion for the listener and for what's told, now interrupted by a second voice, thinner, higher, uncertain, querying, it seems, an invitation to be met, stirring anticipation, embodying incompletion of time and the day. My son, my firstborn, and his mother are involved in a story no longer only theirs, for I am implicated, all three of us now, clinging to expectancy, riding sound and air. Will my first morning of heaven be this? No, and this is not my last morning on earth. I am simply last in my house to waken, and the first sound I hear is the voice of one I love, speaking to one we love. I hear it through the bedroom wall. Something, someday, I'll close my eyes to recall.